If you go on to enjoy the video, please consider hitting that like button and subscribing. It does really help me out a lot. And if you're into Funko Pops, I've just started a brand new channel dedicated to them. The link for that can be found in the description. And beat the random lottery that is FIFA points by buying the coins direct from u7buy.com. Use code TVM at checkout for a 5% discount. Or if you're a new customer, get 8% discount. The link is down below. What is going on, guys? FIFA here. Welcome back to a brand new player review. Jesse Lingard. I know there are so many players I could have reviewed, but why have I chosen Jesse Lingard? I'm a huge Man United fan. I'm joking. Of course, I am a Liverpool fan. And not that I like to admit it these days, but still. Got to take the rough with the smooth. 84 rated, second in form Jesse Lingard. Came out of a pack, untradeable. I mean, he's very desirable right now. He is one of the most searched up players on Footbin in the last 24 hours. I think the reason for that, of course, is because Jesse Lingard is a bit of a... He's a bit of a meme, but at the moment he's actually playing really well. And it just goes to show what a little change of scenery can do for you. This card actually looks pretty good. I'm not ruling out a team of the season, you know. I don't think so, but I'm not ruling it out. Like, he's one of those that you never know. And he could end up getting some sort of, like, summer heat card through the summer. We'll have to wait and see what happens with those type of promos. But 4-star skills, 3-star weak foot, high work rates, lean body type, 5'9". He's got decent building blocks for, like, a box-to-box-esque. I would still prefer to play him as a cam or centre-forward, even a winger. Maybe even a striker than I would a centre mid. But at the same time, it's not completely unfeasible that he might be able to play as a centre mid, like a box to box. A shadow is definitely an option. I've given him a hawk because he's not a player that I'm going to look to play with much. I mean, to be fair, he wasn't bad, and I'll get into that. But, you know, he's not a player that really floats my boat. So I thought, well, I'll give him a hawk. I've got plenty of those just to boost up that pace. A little bit of finishing. Give him a little bit more strength because it's... You know, it is lacking. Not that it's going to help anything. Even if I had to give him 10, it still wouldn't help. But still, yeah, I thought I'd just give him a little bit of a nudge in the right direction. Hawk is not a chem style I would go with. Although, the long shots go up to 97. I think that helped in one of his goals. His shot power is already ridiculous, but we take that up to 99. And then, of course, his finishing and his positioning get a little nudge as well in the right direction, which is good. I mean, the card in general, great agility, decent pace, not amazing, but decent. Great shot power and positioning. This is an 84-rated card. You know, he's got those really good building blocks, the short passing, the vision, the dribbling, the ball control, the finishing. For an 84, it's a very good card. And I think if you were to play him in objectives, for example, you'd have a lot more success than if you were to take him into division rivals or weekend league. But at the same time, it's not a ridiculous idea to take him into Rivals or indeed into Weekend League. I mean, we've got him in Rivals here. He didn't really do an awful lot when I played with him in Rivals. You know, he did the basics well enough. Short passing was solid. His interceptions were okay. Even though he doesn't have great defensive stats, he is still capable of putting in a tackle. And that's kind of FIFA 21 for you, you know. You don't really need to be very good at tackling. You just need to be able to... Well, you just need to be a body in the way, really, because it doesn't matter whether you can tackle or not. As long as you're in the way, there is a chance you're going to be able to get the ball. And that, of course, if you give him a shadow, is only going to be heightened and he's going to be a little bit better. His interceptions are still going to be awful regardless. He does intercept the odd thing, but most of the time the ball will sort of just roll past his feet. And he'll just stand there looking at it, which is just obviously not what you want. But that is only really going to come into play if you use him as that box-to-box that we talked about at the beginning. I'm not a massive fan of using players like this as box-to-box because it's not that it's, you know, not that he's not capable of doing it because FIFA is a little bit different to real life. If I use Jesse Lingard as a box-to-box midfielder in real life, I think it might be a little bit disappointed. But in FIFA, you can get away with it. However, I do feel like you're wasting a little bit of what he's capable at or of if you don't play him as a cam. Now, if you're going into a Rivals game, a Weekend League game, and you're playing him as a cam, you are probably going to be bumping out someone who is better, much better. Because at this stage of the game, we all have reasonably good squads, if not god squads, right? Teams that, until Team of the Season comes out, you're probably not going to want to switch up because there's not an awful lot of things to switch up. So if you do end up going with Jesse Lingard, you are probably going to be downgrading massively. Even though, you know, I don't say necessarily to look at this for a goal. Bang. What a finish that is. How has he scored that? long shot boost, mate. It has to be. And the shot power on the next one as well. The next goal he scores in this game. Look at the shot power. It's outrageous. What a finish. Can't believe that went in. I was actually in shock that it went in. That's why I watched so much of the celebration. And my opponent likes to watch that. They all do that sort of really weird group Macarena type celebration against me. I don't know. Is that a thing? Look at that for shot power. Oof. What a goal. Yeah, so I feel the need to, you know, do a little celebration back every time someone scores and does that against me. I just don't understand it. Anyway, this is a card, basically, what I'm saying, for objectives. I don't think you're going to want to boost out your 88, 90 plus rated players for this guy. He's not bad, not by any stretch of the imagination. I actually had a lot of fun with him. He's reasonably good at everything, really. He's a bit of an all-rounder. But in terms of objectives, he could be a massive help to you in Managerial Masterpiece because he's not too high rated. He's 5 overall higher than the base, you know, the max amount you're allowed. So 79 rated team, and he's 5 overall higher, which does mean he's going to offset the balance slightly. But if you can put 3 65 rated silvers on your bench and you can get away with using some sort of 75, 76 rated players elsewhere, you will definitely be able to get Jesse Lingard and others into your team. And with goals like that and with the sort of agility that he has, the ball control, the reactions were snappy, the passing is very good for an 84. There weren't really that many negatives to speak of because we're reviewing him in that objective setting. I'm not talking about comparing him to Messi or anything. That's why he's got a 90. That's why his value for coins are up there, because you can get an awful lot out of this guy if you just play him in the objective modes and don't take it too seriously. And he can actually offer you a lot. Strength-wise, he's never going to muscle anyone off the ball, whether you give him a shadow, an anchor. Obviously, shadow doesn't affect strength, but you know what I mean? Whether you give him an anchor, whether you just give him a powerhouse, it's not going to make any difference whatsoever to that strength. He's got a lean body type. He's only 5'9". He's going to get muscled off the ball regardless. The other things, of course, the composure. Few issues here or there with not playing the ball quick enough, not shooting quick enough. Sort of misplaced pass here or there because he's under pressure. It doesn't happen a lot, but it's definitely worth sort of remembering that he's not going to be that type of card. He's not going to be Messi. He is only 84 rated. And of course, finally, we have that weak foot. It would be so much better if he had 4-star, 4-star, especially for the sort of cam position that he would be playing in. If he came out as a foot birthday, this would be an unbelievably desirable card. He would be so good. But as it stands, I had a lot of fun with him for around, what, 40k, 50k? Probably going to come down a little bit more over the coming days, especially with that guaranteed team of the week. People will probably be packing him a lot, selling the ones that they have. Maybe you've packed him yourself. For about 40, 50k though, it's bang on the money. It's a great card for objectives. And I like him a lot. There's not an awful lot of downside to this, to be honest. Let me know what you think of him in the comments. If you have enjoyed this player review, hit the like button. Subscribe to the channel for new. And until the next time, goodbye.